We're gonna start out with a an arm lock drill, and we'll do that for like 10 or 15 minutes, but then I'm gonna focus on close guard. So, legs locked, okay? I'm gonna work on getting this arm to the center, okay? I want this elbow somehow in the center of my center line, or be my, you know, in line with my sternum, okay? I don't want it out here on my hip, because I'm not gonna be able to move. Every time I try to move, it's gonna be stuck, okay? So, cross grip on his sleeve, okay? I'm gonna work for a tricep or armpit grip here. Turn the side a little bit. That's good. Here, I'm gonna work to drag this arm to the center. That's gonna make the width of his shoulders a little bit less. I'm gonna be able to climb over the top of his shoulder. Okay, cross my ankles, pinch my knees. The nice thing about this is he cannot pull his arm out. Right? Just hold it there. Okay? So now I can control his wrist. I'm lifting my hips up. When I drop my hips, I'm gonna go underneath his leg. For the arm bar, okay? Knees pinched. Angle the left leg out. So he tries to posture. It's hard for him to pick me up, okay? I don't want my legs over his back. Posture, right? No good. So this leg is gonna angle. This one's gonna angle. Toes pulled up, okay? Now, hip up, get your finish, okay? I can hold his leg, finish it with the one hand, or use both, okay? If I let go of his leg, he's probably gonna turn into me and try to put pressure on my ribs with that knee that I'm underhooking with my right arm, okay? So here, drag to the middle, okay? Now, I can open. I'm covering his shoulder, okay? Pinch my knees, hold him with the wrist. I'm gonna dive under his leg. That's my angle for the arm lock. Finish right here, okay? Tight, okay?
Or do you have any recommendations for getting control of the arm or stronger?
Yes, so if he's really trying to dig it, okay? We're gonna talk about that this week. My hand, I'm gonna go underneath, grab my wrist. I'm gonna use this to punch up as I bring my knees to my chest. Here, right, I have it moved, right? He's not gonna stay here, I'm gonna start to control him. That's when I go over the top. Once I have, see how wide my knees are now? Pinch them tight. He's not pulling that arm out, he can't, okay? I could go here, right to the finish too, okay? Here. But I like to get control of this leg too. So I'm gonna lift, drop, and pull my knees to my chest, and then I'm here, okay? It's hard for him to stack me here. If he tries to move, pull him down, finish. Okay? Does that make sense? The reason I'm showing this particular setup to the arm lock is because it's easier to attain. That old school three-step arm bar where you pull the arm across and then you kick the armpit and you're shifting your hips and all that stuff, nobody lets you do that in a roll. Does that make sense? For those of you that have been training for a while.
When you say the old school, you mean placing the foot in the hip?
Yeah, so old school three-step arm bar. So here, foot to the hip, yeah. Big kick here. That's too many steps, it's too slow, okay? Get his arm in the middle. Here, open over the top, pinch. He's stuck here, right? Under, finish, okay? There's multiple submissions here. Here, right? I have a bunch of things that I can switch to as well from the same spot, okay? I wanna focus on purely the arm bar right now. Anybody got questions on that? So I started off with that arm bar drill just for us to work on some attacks from there. There's a ton of attacks from closed guard. There's a lot of sweeps, back takes, bunch of stuff we can do. It's relatively safe because you can be pretty conservative as a bottom player there, especially if you're less skilled or you're newer. It gives you a little bit of ability to just not get killed in 2 seconds, right? You can at least try to slow the game down a little bit. All right, so we're gonna work on focusing. Everything's gonna be kind of based off of getting to the back. As he defends that, everything else opens up. That arm bar is not my first move. That's when he tries to keep from getting this arm pushed all the way across my center line, okay? When he stops that arm, that's when I'm gonna attack it, okay? So for the back, I'm gonna try to get this arm all the way across, all right? Close guard tight, lift my hips, right? Extend my legs so that it's tight. I'm squeezing his ribs. Cross grip here. If I just get the armpit grip, that's fine. It's a material, turn a little bit this way. Okay, that's good. This material on his gi, it's gonna be on every gi, you can grab it, okay? Elbow's okay, the problem is he's gonna be able to pull back with his elbow. Pull your elbow in, yeah. I don't wanna have to fight that. If I get behind his elbow, that lever point, he's never gonna pull past where my hand is, right? I'm strong here, okay? So now, I'm gonna lift my hips. When I drop my hips, I'm gonna push the arm all the way across as I pull my knees in. Okay, turn. Okay, so once I push this across, I'm gonna straighten my right arm. Okay, he tries to come back, I wrap his lat with my left arm. Okay, I'm gonna extend my legs, turn my hips. Okay, switch legs. Okay, so I'm out to the side. All right, from here, he tries to posture. I'm extremely heavy here. It's hard for him to pick me up. Now I'm gonna finally let go with this right arm, and I'm gonna open my arm, come up to my elbow, okay? From here, I'm gonna come up to my hand. We'll turn a little bit.
This is good.
And I turn. So I'm here, turn, put my knee on the mat. I'm hooking his hip with my leg, okay? From here, I can get his collar, and I'm gonna just connect my hands to break down his shoulder, okay? I can go here to get both hooks. He's been training for a while. He's not gonna let me just get both hooks easy. Okay, so I'm holding his lapel, right? And I'm gonna go right to connect in my hands. Get onto my side, okay? I get my seatbelt, turn. Here, tight ear to ear, okay? No space for him to start on his defense. Any questions on that? I know some of you have probably seen this a million times. It's not rocket science. If you can get that to happen, you're gonna be ahead of them every time, okay? It's how good can you get at getting that to happen, all right? Here, side bend, get to the tricep or the armpit part of the grip. I'm gonna lift my hips. When I drop them, I push it across as I pull my knees to my chest. Here, okay? As I reach up, I'm gonna switch my hips. Here, lock my legs, okay? So now I'm kind of sideways on him. As he tries to posture, I'm super heavy, okay? I'm gonna arch my back, come up to my elbow, and I keep my chest on his shoulder, okay? Now I can start to climb him, okay? Unlock my legs. I'm gonna turn my left knee to the mat. Here, okay? Now I reach under, get his lapel. I'm just gonna connect my hands. Pull to the side. Good. All right. The majority of time, you're gonna be able to break them down, especially if you get to their back that quick. Okay. If I don't, real quick.
Sure.
I'm just gonna get to that slide. So I'm holding that lapel. Okay. I could step off and pull him too. All right. Get into his side. So here, pull him down. That's another way to get him, okay? And I'm right in on my attacks. I wanna focus on just getting to that back with the same control, connecting my hands and pulling him onto that shoulder. All my weight's gonna be on that one side. Break down that, the one shoulder he's got, okay? His far side arm, I'm not worried about that yet. That's the counter when he defends this, okay? Anybody got questions?